You really aren't getting tired of that, are you? Just stop flailing around like an incompetent.
Space trial. Putting the system on trial. In space. Space system. On trial. Guilty. Not being in space. Go to space jail.
Hey guys, I'm here with a new video, and as you can tell, I got something big. I got something big to show off. This is probably the biggest thing I've had to review since doing this new, kind of a smaller setup. So, hopefully I'll be able to shoot this well. If not, we'll have to deal. But today, it is my sheer and utter delight to bring to you the NECA Player Select Portal, Aperture Laboratories handheld portal device, the Portal Gun. The absolute, probably prize of my kind of 1-1 scale prop replica roleplay kind of stuff that I have. This thing is fantastic. And limited. I hate to say it, but a lot of you guys, if you're just now hearing about this, it potentially could be too late. Because these things, they're only 5,000 in the world. Now, I don't see any kind of numbering system on this, but that's just what NECA has told us. They are only producing 5,000. So every single place that has had a pre-order, gone. They're all sold out. ThinkGeek is where I got mine. They were the last ones to get theirs in stock, and I hear they sold it within half an hour. So if they do re-release this in some fashion, there are rumors that they're going to release them in their co-op colors. You know, have the, whereas the standard is blue, and then, whoop, oh, hey, wait, look, hey, look, there you go. Blue and orange. The co-op will have red and orange, and then another one that'll have blue and purple. But here's the packaging. It is very, very basic. It is scuffed up, which I'm okay with. If you want one that's in pristine condition, suck it up. That's just what it's gonna be. ThinkGeek even put a notice in the product description that the box would have scuffs, it would have scrapes, it's got little holes in it. It's just, the box is not the essential part of this. So, it does look nice, it is great, but you open the box up and there are foam inserts inside that hold the gun in place. There is plastic wrap that surrounds it. But the main attraction, the main reason you are buying this, is for this baby right here. This is the Portal Gun. And it's so nice to have in person. Like, this thing, from what I read, it's 30 inches from base to if you have the hooks fully extended. It's got a nice weight to it. It does feel kind of toy-y, if that makes any kind of sense. But it's got some really, really nice weight. I would say it's about 5 pounds easily. And my light is going ballistic from all this. All the little details are there. The Aperture Laboratories logo, which, focus camera, focus. The little portal, the Aperture logos on the sides are all there. One problem I do have, there is some slight scraping underneath that hook, if you can see that. It's nothing too major. I can look past it, but if you are someone who is a very, very, no scratches, no blemishes kind of guy, you may have some issues with this. But it just looks great. Each of the hooks are articulated. At the point there, and the point up there, so you can have them in any number of positions. I like going for the kind of standard, you know, have them kind of like that kind of look. And it's just great. The batteries go here. It does take 3 C batteries that are not included. If you buy it from ThinkGeek, then you can buy batteries with it. This just unscrews, all 3 go in. And one thing I love about this, the on-off switch is not obtrusive at all. I was really worried it would have kind of a switch somewhere on it, and then a button system to change things around. If you look inside there, you may see it. Up at the top, if I can get my lighting just right, which I doubt I can, but there's a little slider switch right up in there. And the way it works is, slide it all the way up for orange, which I'll go ahead and kill this now. Slide it all the way back for blue. So you can see, and that's off, obviously. You can see how easy it is to change all the settings. And that's how it looks just by itself. It looks fantastic. That blue glow just has me giggling. You can see each of the hooks have a little red LED, which does add a lot to the gun itself. The barrel, of course, does light up with its corresponding color. So, and that's one thing I absolutely love. I love how easy it is to change. This kind of does feel like how it would be in the game. You would have a gun, or you would have a switch, fire your portal, and then hit a switch just like that. Now, as you notice, it has sounds. If you go to orange, it does have some distinct sounds. They are roughly the same, but there are some subtle changes to it. And of course, if you hold it down, we just get a few. And of course, you can go. Who hasn't done that once in the game? Who really hasn't done that once? If you go to blue, the portal sounds are very similar, but there, again, there's a subtle difference. And there you go. That's really it. I really am glad this thing sounds better in person. NECA had a video up that kind of demonstrated how it sounded. At least I think it was NECA. It could have just been someone who got theirs. And it sounded kind of muffled in the video. It didn't sound really crystal clear. And I was afraid it would sound really cheap when you got it. This thing sounds clear. It sounds perfect. I'm not sure how it sounds in the video, but it sounds as if it's straight from the game. I love it. I really, really do. Now, if you can find one of these, pick it up. On eBay, they are going for outrageous prices. Whatever you are doing, do not buy it from a third-party seller unless you are desperate to have one. I'm talking eBay prices of $500 plus more. These things, their retail price is about $140. If you got it from ThinkGeek, they had an option for free shipping and then battery costs. $140 feels perfect. I was worried it would feel kind of cheap for that kind of price, but the plastic feels nice and sturdy. It's weighted, so you can just prop it up. There's no need for a stand. You could make your own stand, but they actually said in the actual release on ThinkGeek that it's weighted, so you don't need a stand. It'll hold its position pretty well. It just has a really nice solid feel to it, and I cannot recommend it to you anymore. I love it. Hopefully they will release more of these in the future, because I realize there's a lot of Portal fans who couldn't get theirs. I was keeping up with the news, and I almost didn't get it. For those of you who have not been keeping up with any kind of information, good luck. Good luck, guys. All I can say to you, it is certainly worth it. It looks astonishing on display, and I have to find a place that will actually accommodate it. A few more things before I do in this video, because I think I've praised it quite a bit. A few more of the details. These little wire bits, they are really solid. I don't know how strong they are, but they do kind of pop back to their position. The hooks, they feel solid, but I kind of wonder if these little black pieces are what's scraping up the other side. So you may have to take some care with that. Just be careful. What I really do like, and it's a stupid thing to praise, but the bottom has no detail at all. So if you do lay this down, there's no worry of details getting scratched off. Everything does look really, really good. And I love it. I do. I love it. I love it. What can I say? If I could marry it, I would marry it. But, yeah, that's all I can really, really say for it. Hopefully NECA does release more of these. If they do the whole co-op kind of thing, which, again, is just rumor at this point. If there's 2,000 each of these, good luck. Good luck. Because 5,000 sold really fast. That's all I can really say, guys. So I'm going to go edit this little thing. And I hope you guys have a great day. Thanks for watching, as always. And take care.